Hello everyone, what is going on? And welcome back to our My Player Career Mode, episode 7 for you today. As always, I hope that you are feeling fantastic, having an awesome day, and I thank you for taking the time to watch one of my videos. Thank you, as well, for the incredible support. We've got Leicester up first, as I show you the calendar. Then we've got a cup tie against Forest before Newcastle in today's episode. Potentially maybe City if we have time as well. Premier League season got underway last episode. We played 4 matches. We've won 1, an opening day victory against Blackburn, which I wasn't in the team for. We were on the bench and we didn't actually come on. Then we lost 3-0 to Spurs. We did come off the bench in that one before picking up a 5-0 win in the cup against Doncaster, scoring 2 goals in that as well. Then a bit of heroics from us, a 90th minute equaliser against Arsenal, in which we were able to get a point before a 4-0 defeat to West Ham. That's how the last episode went. Today, we're looking to bounce back. We want to pick up as many points as we can. So without further ado, I just want to get into some matches. We are close to level 20, 81 overall. Let's just play some games, see how we get on, and see if we can pick up some points. And as we go into the first game of the day, I'm looking at the two lineups here, and I honestly think we've got a good chance at 3 points. Remind me of that when full time is sounded and we've not picked up 3 points. Schlup, Ayew, Schlup, Ayew. Brilliant! Pavlenka saves. Palace 12 minutes in, first chance of the game, and this is more like it from us. Got to build on this. And after that 4-0 defeat to West Ham, that's good to see that we have the first chance of the afternoon here. Corner ball, what can we do with this? It's in towards the middle, Vestergaard away. Will we get there first? No, Daka is the first player to get to the ball. And he lofts it forwards, which Mitchell is underneath here. Great control, but then gives it away to De Frutos. And this is danger for Palace then. And you can see I'm using the contain button. You lovely people in the comments section help me out to understand how I activate that. And we win the ball back pretty quickly. So thank you for all your help with that. For reference, because I can't remember if I said it in the last clip, the teammate contain button is the RB on Xbox or R1 on PlayStation. So yeah, as I said, that came from you lovely people in the comments section. This is dangerous territory. Madison's standing over the Leicester free kick. I really want to go on the line here, but I don't think I'm going to reach it in time. Madison going to go over the wall, but it's blocked by the wall. And Gaita comes out and it's a mistake. And Mitchell, well done to him. Because otherwise, that looked like it was a certain goal for Leicester. And in the end, we deal with it, but just about after what should have been a routine save for Gaita. Here now then is Hughes, finding Ayew. Ayew will lay it towards me. Palace up the other end, searching for a chance themselves. We'll go back here for Hughes. Hughes carrying on, finding Ayew, near post, Pavlenka saving. Wow. From a Leicester chance to a Palace, great, glorious opportunity. Somehow it's not in. But here is a chance for Daka, Leicester. Daka cut out by Anderson. Great work from him. And we go back towards Hughes just to keep us on the ball. Hughes can find Mitchell, who can play it to Ayew. Ayew got a couple of options in front of him, in myself and Schlup. Schlup's ball towards me. We've seen the run of Mitchell. It's a brilliant ball. Can Mitchell finish it off though? He cannot, but Palace are on top. And this is great to see. Overlapping run here from Mata. There is the ball towards him. Palace down the right now. Mata finding me with a great ball back. And can we open up the chance to shoot? We have done. How has Pavlenka saved that? And then when we get the chance like that, somehow we haven't scored it. Change for Leicester. But I don't know how we're not won the lot. Meyer, MacArthur. Good ball from MacArthur. We cut inside. Ayew's given us the run. Jordan Ayew, this is the moment for us, maybe. No, because Pavlenka again makes the save. Third or fourth of the game now for the Leicester goalkeeper. Nice ball through. Ayew goes for goal. Nearly makes it count. Lovely ball, Daka. And that's the goal. Leicester break the deadlock at the King Power Stadium. Oh, man. Chances we've had as well. The frustration for us. I'm still trying to work out this team press. I know that if I press the button, it does activate now, though, at least. I'm just trying not to have players get dragged out of position. And Patson Daka, sight of goal, finishes it off. But honestly, this game could have gone either way because both teams have had their chances. And Pavlenka's made some very good saves in the Leicester goal. And although we are 1-0 down, in terms of our performance, We actually haven't played too bad here. Ito. Ayu. Ito again. Back to Ayu. These two exchanging passes. Ball now going forward to MacArthur, but it's cut up by Vestergaard. Now Meyer takes over for Palace. Now Hughes towards Ayu. Ayu's got the pass. And we have got away from the challenge. Bearing down on the Leicester goal. There it is. Just when we needed it. It is 1-1. Ayu's ball through. We finish it off. And can we get our noses in front and actually take the 3 points? We've still got about 10 minutes left here. In fairness, a draw would be probably a fair reflection on the way the game has gone. Don't think either side really deserve to lose the game. But can anyone find the winner? I actually got the time wrong. We've only got about 5 minutes left, not 10 as I first thought, as that challenge advantage played by the referee. Ayu, he's away. He's in the box. Jordan Ayu, Pavlenka with the right hand saves. 2 minutes left of the 90. Leicester holding on, you could say, to this draw as Ito gets the ball back but then gives it straight away. That was the moment for us to be able to try and keep the pressure on. And a mistake from the pass, which happened a few times, to be fair. Like, there's a few moments where we're not under too much pressure and we give away the ball with a simple pass. We need to try and cut that out if we can. But honestly, in terms of performance, much, much better here from Palace. And we're not done there. 3 minutes added on. Ball's got to go forward, though, because if we keep going back, the referee will blow his whistle. Ito trying the first-time ball, which I didn't actually ask for. And that will be full-time. Leicester 1, Palace 1. 2 goals, 7 minutes apart. I said the draw would be a fair reflection. 10 shots for Leicester, 11 for Palace. Very, very even game. City beating Newcastle. Some of the other results as well you can see there, as we do now have level 20 and a man of the match performance as well to go with it, which means we've got 3 more skill points to allocate. I believe we've now got the Carabao Cup tie against Forest, which we have been drawn at home for. So home advantage for this. You know what? A cup run might be quite fun this season. So let's see what we can do in this one. And there are the two lineups then for this cup tie. Forest on the right, we are on the left. Won't be an easy game this one though. You've got to say that. Forest, give them credit. They will cause us problems. Morgan Gibbs-White finding Toffolo. What we don't want is an early goal the way of Forest, because that will make it a very, very tough evening here. With the home advantage, we want to give our fans something to shout about. That ball from Rochez has got us away seemingly, and we know we've got a near post finish in us a few times. It's there again. It's so, so efficient when we're in front of goal to hit that near post. 6 minutes gone at Selhurst Park. It's Palace 1, Forest 0. And our cup run that we're hoping for may continue here. And you can see once we get away, that pace is deadly. So deadly. So too is the near post finish. Schluck trying to find a space in the middle. Alana's ball out wide. Will I be onside? I am. Where's the runs in the box, though? Where are the runs in the box from Palace? It's across to Hughes, to Rochez. What a save. Yep, that's my reaction, mate. I don't know how it's not 2-0 either. Hughes selfless. That is a great stop. Lallana will take the eventual corner for Palace, and he's aimed it towards me. I'm not going to win that header, I'll tell you that right now. But Schluck will pick up the pieces, and he will play it towards us again. Looking to place it this time into that far corner. Nice try, said the thing at the top, but it wasn't really that close in the end. But that's the little bit of confidence we've now got. Back-to-back goals. One against Leicester, one against Forest. Starting to play with a bit of confidence. Lallana with a corner. And it's half an hour gone here. The second for Palace would be fantastic right about now. Gibbs-White does win the header and does really well to find Dennis, who's holding off the challenge. But there's the defensive work rate from us as we're back supporting Mata, getting Palace back on the ball. And as the first half goes, this is probably one of my better ones in a Palace shirt. I've got to be honest. Schlupp has done well here to get in behind. Still Schlupp, and still now looking to pick out the pass. And can we keep the pressure on? Meyer's header. Will I get there? Yes, we will. Ball could go into the box here. It's the cross looking for Lallana. Cook away. Forest just having to basically, every time the ball is cleared, it comes back at them. And they're just having to try and find a way to deal with us right now. And they're not really doing that as we go past 2 challenges. And it's in the top corner. I said it was probably the best we're playing in a Palace shirt. And I stand by that. 2-0. Cup run, anyone? And this is one of my favourite celebrations. I told you before in FIFA 22, I love that one. Look at this. What's going on? We're having a field day. Oh, this is brilliant to watch. Uh-oh, that is not something you want to see. Mistake made. Can Burkhart make us pay for it? Finding Dennis straight at Gaita. Wow, that was the first chance that Forest had found. And it came from a Palace mistake. Emmanuel Dennis hitting the shot, though, straight at Vicente Gaita. Morgan Gibbs-White allowed to run a long way here. Now Burkhart, Vardiol in the way, but it comes here for Dennis instead again. Will the offside flag come? I'm not sure. It does not. And Emmanuel Dennis, who had that chance right before the break, does not pass up this opportunity. Dennis scores. Forest back in the game. And it was an interesting one because Morgan Gibbs-White had taken the ball pretty much the full length of Palace's half before a challenge came in. And then he finds Burkhart, who puts the ball through to Dennis. And like we say, he doesn't pass up this opportunity. Firing home. And for a game that we've been in complete control of, we are now a little bit nervous. Just need to try and get control back of this one because we've let it go a little bit. We were so good in that first half. We did not allow Forest even really a sight of goal until the end of it. And that was through a mistake. So here we go again then on the attack. Rochez to Ito. Ito looking to set me away. The touch is not great, but I'm still battling away for it. Almost coming away from it. Oh my goodness me! It is a calamity from Forest goalkeeper. But it's the tenacious work rate from us which gets us our first hat-trick in a Crystal Palace shirt. I would never in a million years think that this would be how we'd get our hat-trick. Wow. Definitely not a foul. Definitely not a foul. And right as Forest might have found a way back into the game, that's how they concede the third goal. Here is Friller into the box. Forest looking for another one. Gaita, though, importantly, saves for Palace. 15 minutes remain, and it will be the end of our evening here. I imagine a standing ovation inside Selhurst Park. A hat-trick for us. As I said, our first in a Palace shirt. Three shots on target. Three goals, a 9.3 match rating. And, of course, we will watch the rest of this game play out. And, hopefully, they won't score twice for us to dampen what has been a very good game for us. I would love to give you a cup run this year and get to a cup final. Morgan Gibbs-White's effort. Palmed over by Gaita. Yeah, I'd really love a cup final with Palace this year if we can. Mangala for Forest. Now finding Johnson. 5 minutes left of the 90. Johnson, Mangala, Friller! 3-2. Do not do this, Crystal Palace. Do not do this. This is going to be a nerve-wracking 4 minutes here. Forest need to get this ball back as quickly as they can from kickoff. Johnson, good work from him. Mangala, he plays the ball through. Johnson gives him it back, and then he sets up Frohler, who scores. And they have got the ball back here, Forest, as there's a strong challenge coming in here from Adam Lallana. He'll probably get booked for this. But it's going to be a free kick and a chance for Forest to put the ball into the box. If they do this and come back here, I am going to be so unhappy. Right, Frohler to take the free kick. And we're not even into added time yet. Ball goes into the box. Away the first ball is from Gvardiol. Andone heads it back though. Meyer can find Ito. Palace need to break away and do it at speed as well if they can. Lallana keeping hold of the ball, finding Mata. Thankfully for us, we seem to have composed ourselves and kept hold of the ball here for long enough to chew down the clock. Ayew, run coming through from Adam Lallana. The offside flag goes up. Thought we would see the offside flag. 2 minutes left then. Can Forest do it? Forward the ball is again. Meyer underneath the first header. Palace have it back. Just keep hold of the ball and it's done. Ito, lovely ball. Finding Jordan Ayew. Certainly done now, but can we find a fourth? Ito! Saved! Well, that's the game, thankfully, as well. Because I thought for a second we were going to see a fight back from Forest, but no. Corner ball, and as soon as this is taken, pretty much the referee will end the game. Ito goes short, plays it back to Adam Lallana. Why not take a shot on? Great ball, Anderson to Ayew. Tries to be selfless, play it across. Referee, where's your full-time whistle? There it is! We're through to the Carabao Cup next round. Hat-trick hero as we collect the match ball as well. That is a brilliant sight to see. I am buzzing. Wood hits hat-trick in Palace win. Apparently, we scored a thrilling hat-trick to overwhelm a woeful Nottingham Forest. I don't think they were woeful. I actually think they didn't do too bad in the second half. First half, yes, maybe. Second half, however, they were good. Birthday preparation. As you can see, we can spend it with the ones we love or a birthday to remember. We did that one last time, so let's go with this one this time. And then we've also got a request a wage increase. What overall do we need for that? Is it 84 possibly? It is 84 because we are now 82 rated. So when I said I wasn't sure if the points in the personality affect your overall, I'm assuming they do because I've not put any skill points into anything and we were 81 rated at the start of this episode. The only thing that has changed is some points into our personality and we've grown in overall. So yeah, they do affect your overall, it looks like. Now, I could try and push for that 84 overall to get the wage increase, but I'm not too bothered about it right now. So I think I'm going to leave it as it is. As we now travel to take on Newcastle. Well, we're at home, so they're traveling to us anyway. Selhurst Park, they've only won one game, and that's a bit of a surprise. More activity to do. So I think if we play well here, the 1-1 draw against Leicester was good. Fell behind, getting the point. Then that hat-trick against Forest. We're in good form. Let's see what we do against this Newcastle side. There it is on your screen. Club record signing, Isak up front. Saliba and Botman at the back. It's a very good defence, actually, that Newcastle have got. So this might be a tough game for us to break them down. MacArthur towards myself. Now Mata. I've given that run. Mata will find me as well. You best believe he will. As we shift it onto the left side. It's a chance and it's a goal. Ha ha! The form continues! Come on! 3 minutes in, and we've scored a goal, and all of a sudden, I don't know what has changed, but something is clicking in this Palace side. After that West Ham game of last episode, I was sat there contemplating my decision to stay. But now, I know we only picked up a point against Leicester, but we were decent there. The hat-trick against Forest, straight into game against Newcastle, and we've got three goals. Well, sorry, no, more than three. What I meant to say is we scored in all three games, consecutive. Leicester, Forest, Newcastle. And we've even got five across those three games right now, and we only played 4 minutes of this one. Guardiola in the way of the pass, as now Hughes finding Ayew. Ayew trying to play it back the way of MacArthur. Intercepted, but it looked like a handball had been used there. Now, last time I had a free kick in this position, I tried to play it short to MacArthur. And then as soon as I did, he ran off. So I'm not going to do it this time. And of course, he stays there this time. I'm going to try and chip it in the box and see. It's just lifted in the air. Saliba away. MacArthur's done really well to win the header as we are able to get it onto the left side. And if you give me a sight of goal at the moment, I'm taking it because we're hitting the target more often than not. Benya's ball, though, and out will come our goalkeeper, Isak, gets there ahead of Vicente Gaita and nods Newcastle back on level terms. Gaita choosing to come out of goal. And in the end, is it the wrong decision? You can see he sets off, but he's too late. The ball just bouncing in front of him, and Isak gets there first. And Newcastle's record signing popping up when they need him. 1-1, but that's Newcastle's first chance of the game. So I'm still confident here. 1 minute added on here at Selhurst Park, and that'll do it for the first half of football. 1-1 at the break. Palace have had more of the ball, but it is all square as things stand. MacArthur to Ayew. Ayew spinning, trying to find the pass. He will find Schlupp. Oh, the touch from Schlupp, though. Oh, he nearly falls the way of Ayew. How have Newcastle got away with that? Free kick Palace for a handball against Sven Botman. Schlupp going off. Ito coming on. Oh, my, we've got the chance. We've been given the opportunity. They've got a player lying down behind the wall. What do I do here? Do I just go for it and hope? Well, we've tried. And it is against the wall. It comes back out for us, though, as we try and drive it to that bottom corner. Wide in the end. I am currently trying to work on free kicks and figure out what's the best way of doing them. If you've got any tips for me, of course, leave it in the comment section. That'd be much appreciated. The only reason I know about the secondary contain is because of you lovely people. So, yeah, any help would be massively appreciated. Newcastle corner. Zygankov He's got the option to go short, and he does now do that to Boehner, who's inside the Palace penalty area. No, I've just pressed the wrong button. I didn't mean to press X. Oh, my finger slipped, and then I saw myself sliding in, and we've given away a penalty. I can't believe I just did that. I cannot believe I just did that. Do you know when you do something, and as soon as you do it, you realise, I don't know why I pressed X. Oh, no. I'm really sorry. Saigankov, he's not going to miss it. That is completely my fault. I misclicked. Oh. We do not deserve to lose this game. We do not deserve it. MacArthur chasing down Saigankov. I'm trying then to not allow the pass back, but he goes forward instead. And Newcastle have tried to play their way forward. And have we seen an offside flag? We have. Trippier was offside. Injury time now then. We have to make one more chance if we want something from a game that honestly we deserve something from. But that doesn't help us as Eto's giving the ball away. Now Saliba, who's almost playing at centre midfield right now. Trippier's in. Trippier's in. And he goes across the face of goal. Anderson prevents it becoming anything. But I don't think we've got the time. Mitchell has to get the ball forward. He hasn't done. Seconds remain. And it'll be it. And because I accidentally pressed the X button, we've lost the game. Oh my goodness. I apologise. I will say, however, other than the obvious mistake that we made there, the episode itself, one win, one draw, one defeat. Admittedly, the win came in the cup and the draw and the defeat was in the league. We actually played well in all three games. Like, it wasn't like we were dominated in any of the three. We were creating chances, and overall, I actually saw a lot of positives from the matches we played. So, yeah, take away that silly moment from me, which again, I apologise for. It's actually not been a bad episode, I think, and it is something for us to build on next time out, where we will start with Manchester City, who are top of the Premier League, yet to lose. So let's hand them their first defeat of the season, shall we? Still early doors, still a lot to play for. I wouldn't worry about the table at all, in all honesty, until we're about halfway through, because it'll change a lot by then. But in case you are wondering, there's the top eight. And as I scroll down, there's 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th, and 20th. Very strange way of doing it, but there you go. I'm interested to see who we've got in the cup, though. Who have we got in the next round? Round four, we will take on Everton. Burnley, Villa, Leicester, Bristol City, Man United, Fulham, City, Brighton, Cardiff, Liverpool, Leighton, Orient, Stoke, West Ham, Chelsea. So that is a tough draw for us, but it's one that I think we might be able to get something from. And as I say, a Carabao Cup final would be an awesome thing to have this season here at Palace. My friends, that will be the end of today's episode. That is all we've got time for today. Unfortunately, I do have uni to go to, but here's the deal. If we hit 600 likes on this episode, I will get you another episode tomorrow. That is the deal. You lot have been smashing the support recently, so I've had to up the likes to 600 for now and see if we can achieve that. We will take a look at our personality overview. Here it is for you. Maverick is what we are dominant in at the moment. Plus 3 attribute boost to the following stats. We do have Heartbeat and Virtuoso in there as well, though, and that is because we've now achieved Tier 2 in the personality, which means we get the plus 3 boost, which is really good. And not only that, player growth. There are our attributes at the moment. 3 archetypes, Maestro, Finisher, Cheater. 3 skill points to use. And I forgot, we unlocked a new perk slot. So before we go today, let's activate a new perk. What should we go with? Pinpoint Crossing is probably a good one. Skill Dribbler, also decent. Assist Streak, Active First Touch, Poacher. We have been popping up in the box a bit more, but I think I'm going to go with Pinpoint Cross for now. And that is what we'll choose for the perk. But yeah, until next time, everyone, stay safe. Have a great day. Have a great evening. And I will catch you all, hopefully, for another episode tomorrow. Look after each other. Until next time. Adios.